powers of mankind with the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ, admonishing them to receive the gift of His Spirit to lift and nurture the total man as we expectantly await the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
I command you to be healed, be delivered, be set free.
What a blessing it is to be coming into your home once again. And I'm just excited for the things that I look forward for God to do for me again. And then I've added some more things to my life. I want a deeper personal walk with Jesus Christ. I want my image, I want everything about me to emulate the Christ that died on the cross for us. That's one of the things I want you to focus on. The enemy wants us to think that we can live any kind of way and then come to God for anything. Yes, He's merciful. The scripture says He daily loadeth us with good things. Now, today's lesson that we are going to go into is one where God knows that there are times when we need restoring. This particular sermon is just called A Service of Restoration. You don't want to miss it. Now, I'm Evangelist Louise Patterson from the beautiful city of Memphis, Tennessee. And I ask you, if you would like to write me at Bountiful Blessings, Post Office Box 1, Memphis, Tennessee, zip 38101. Our web address, BeBlessed.org. If you would like to call an operator, we have a toll-free number. That number is 1-800-544-3571. Now, I want you to be excited about going to church with us, this particular service. I want you, when you see the saints rejoice, when you see the word go forth, accept the deliverance that's right now present for you. Let's go to church.
Right now, receive and receive and receive it. Receive and receive it. Receive and receive it. Receive and receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it right now. Restore the need you saw empty. Let it restore. Let it restore.
Hallelujah. I want you for a moment just join hands or touch that person that is next to you. Hallelujah. God, we just have to thank you, because even this day, you have ordained it as a day of restoration for your people. Said in the second chapter of the book of Joel, and I will restore the year that the locusts have eaten. Oh, God, before us today, there are people who it seems like the locusts and the caterpillar and every carnivorous insect has been flying around looking for the seed that have been planted by your people. And in many instances, the devil seemingly found the seed and devoured it. But I thank you for your promise. Shekora Bahasate, that I'm restoring the year. I feel the wind of restoration. Feel the glory of your presence.
restoring all that the enemy has taken away. Hey, thank you. And we just gonna praise you for it. We have your promise. And you're not a man that you can lie. Not a son of man that you could repent. If you said it, you're going to do it. And right now, we're praising you because you're doing just what you said. Come on and begin to give him praise. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Take your seat if you can. Oh, hallelujah. 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 We're standing on his promise today. Oh, take your seat if you can. So many ways of dealing with his people. God had decided that Israel and Judah, mostly Judah, that their sins before him were of such that he couldn't get their attention no other way. And in order to get their attention, he had to do something drastic. He sent a devastating plague of locusts. And not only did the locusts destroy the seed, well, the plant that was in the field, let me say it that way. He not only destroyed the plant in the field, but destroyed the seed for the next year's crop. So that meant they were messed up for this year's harvest and didn't have nothing to plant for next year's harvest. And I know it looked like that's what has happened in the lives of so many of God's people. He has allowed the enemy to just snatch away the little bit you thought you had, and that you had laid away, he took that too. And now you're standing at the crossroads, wondering which way to go. But he told them, all that you do, blow the trumpet in Zion. sound the alarm in my holy mountain. Tell even the elders. And you know, preachers don't like the cry. I had to hit this at the women's convention. Reason a lot of times we don't get answers is because we have people who are praying that's not really broken. A lot of us don't even know the secret of brokenness. But my Bible tells me that the Lord is nigh, and that means near, to them who are of a broken heart. And sometimes God lets some things happen to break you, to break that old stubborn spirit. He had to let the enemy invade your finance. Had to let the enemy invade your family. Had to let the enemy touch your physical body. Because the Lord said, when you come before me, I want you to come before me broken. Then, if you think I can't use a broken vessel, just give me a chance. Because when you get through preachers weeping between the porch and the altar, when you get through sounding the alarm, when you get through coming before me with tears, I will restore. God said, you up here worrying about a few days, but I hear him say, I'll restore the year. And some of you, the stuff that's happened in your life, it didn't happen overnight. You didn't get in the shape you got into overnight. No need to get mad at God because it looked like your deliverance isn't coming overnight. Touch somebody and tell them you didn't get in that mess overnight. It took you a while to get messed up. You played church for years. You played church for months. You act like you had what you didn't have for a long time. But I hear the Lord say, come before me with a sincere heart. I will restore. What do you mean? Restore simply means to give it back. And I don't know how we got into this trend. But the last Sunday that I preached, I talked about the fact that God said that he would, David, if you go after what the Amalekites stole, said, I want you to know you're going to catch the Amalekites. And you're going to not only do that, you're going to recover your wives and your children. And not only that, you're going to recover all that the Amalekites have stolen. Now here's Joel in one place, David in another. But he told David, said, I want you to know that I'm going to let you get back everything.